I was 17. I had been feeling pretty terrible for a while. They kept putting it off towards other things. And then finally they did blood work and it was considered end stage liver failure. I thought it was kind of the end of the world. I didn't really expect to get past much, maybe 25 years old. Why start a career? Why start a family? Why do any of that stuff if you're so sick that they don't think you're gonna make it that far? They said that I would need a new liver within about 2 years, or I would not be here. I kind of was more determined to prove people wrong. I went into fire academy. I ate better. I worked out a lot. I did everything that I could to live as best of a lifestyle as I could to give myself the best odds. I lasted 16 more years at that stage. I was 32 and I started to feel pretty crummy. I had a lot of fluid in my legs. I had a lot of fluid in my stomach. I was having a hard time breathing, headaches, bad fevers, night sweats. I got very jaundiced. I needed a liver. So when they told me that I would need a transplant, it was terrifying, but also it was like, finally, I'm gonna maybe have an opportunity to feel like a normal person for a day, especially having a son, a toddler. You know, I wanna be there for him. I wanna be able to match his energy and play with him and, you know, do cool stuff and be a cool dad. Eventually I went on the donor list and within 2 weeks I was lucky enough to get an offer. I had just dropped my kid off at school and I was just sitting there and got a phone call from the Chicago area code, and I picked up the phone and they were like, hey, we got an offer for you. And do you want it? And it was like, yes, like, let's go. You know, my son's about to turn 3 years old. I'm gonna be here for that. He's the reason I'm here. My donor was a stranger. How would you thank someone for such a gift like that, except for by living your best life?